Hey everyone, welcome back to Chow Chow 2025. Today we're diving into the world of ComfyUI, and I'm going to show you step by step how to load a GGUF model file. This is crucial for running powerful models right on your PC. If you're wondering what GGUF is, especially those confusing Q4KM names, you're in the right place. Let's get started. GGUF stands for GPT-Generated Unified Format. Initially developed for large language models, LLMs, it has become a popular, optimized file format used to store and run a wide variety of AI models efficiently on consumer hardware. For example, while you might use GGUF for an LLM like Llama, you can also use it for models like WAN 2.2 or other specialized neural networks that have been converted to this format. Here's why GGUF is so powerful: efficiency. GGUF is highly optimized for fast loading and inference, meaning you can run powerful models even without a super expensive high-V RAM GPU. Metadata: GGUF files contain useful information about the model, making them easier to manage and use across different platforms, including ComfyUI. Quantization: this is the most crucial part. GGUF supports various quantization levels, Q2, Q4, Q8, etc. This process reduces the precision of the model's weights, for example, from 16-bit down to 4-bit. This makes the file much smaller and faster to run, with surprisingly little impact on the model's performance. When you go to download a GGUF model, you'll see file names like model14bq4km.gguf or model14bq50.gguf. Let's decode this. Understanding Q2 to Q8, the Q followed by a number, like Q2, Q4 or Q8, refers to the quantization level, Q2 to Q3 smallest size, lowest quality and usually for quick testing or very constrained systems, low VRAM GPU. Q4 best balance of size and quality recommended for most users, good speed, balance, size and quality trade-off. Q5, Q6 larger size for higher quality and slightly slower generation. Q8 largest size with highest quality, closest to the original full precision model. The general rule is, higher Q number equal larger size, slower speed, higher quality. When in doubt, use Q4. Q4 is as bad as you can go down, below that you sacrifice a lot the quality. Decoding the codes after the Q level. The codes that follow the Q level, like _K_M, indicate the specific quantization scheme used. Standard schemes _0_1. These are older, simpler quantization methods. They work, but there are better options now. K-Quantization schemes _K_K_S_K_M. The K stands for K-Quants, which are advanced, modern quantization algorithms. They use mixed precision to retain higher quality while achieving excellent compression. _K_S_Small, optimized for the smallest sizes. _K_M_Medium, the most popular, it's the balance scheme. _K_L_Large, used for better quality models. Your takeaway: for the best mix of performance and speed, look for a Q4_K_M model. Or you could try Q5_K_S if that available. Now that we know what GGUF is, let's get it loaded into ComfyUI. Get your GGUF model first, download your chosen GGUF file. Hugging Face is a great resource, just search for models with the .gguf extension. Make sure you know where you saved it. You should put it at the same place as the other model. For example, WAN model should be put in models/diffusion models. Launch ComfyUI, go to Manager. Search for ComfyUI GGUF, click Install and Restart when asked. I will not restart since I already install it. Now in this example I use our WAN 2.1 text-to-video workflow. Just double-click and there is two GGUF loader, that is UNET Loader and Clip Loader with its variant. Anyway, we're going to load WAN model, so use UNET Loader. Now I have downloaded GGUF model for WAN 2.1, that is WAN 2.1 T2V Fusion X Vase Q4KS.gguf. I will open this model and change the load diffusion models with this node. Fusion X is also contain ICVID and CourseVID, so there is nothing to be changed on the workflow. As you can see, it is working. You've successfully loaded a quantized GGUF model. You are no longer limited by your VRAM. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment. Please subscribe to Chow Chow 2025 for more efficient ComfyUI workflows. See you again on the next episode and have a nice day.